Our speaker of the days. We are starting with the third day of this International Faculty Development Program. So informally starting with taking the divine blessings of His Holiness Jagat Guru Shri Shri Shivratri Deshikendra Mahaswami Ji, the 25th Pontiff of Suttur Math, our Chief Patron. I would also like to take opportunity to welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Vinay Kumar Pathak Ji, our Dr. C.G. Surmath Executive Secretary JSS Mahavidya Peetha, Professor M.S. Dhananjay Sir, Advisor JSS TED, JSS Mahavidya Peetha, our Dr. C. Ranganathaiya Sir, who is the Director Technical Education, PND, JSS Mahavidya Peetha. I also thank the coordinators of JSS Academy of Technical Education, Noida, who supported us with keen interest in giving the weightage and the equal, you can say, opportunity to organize this International Faculty Development Program. Of them, our Chief Command, our Chief Administrative Officer, Monroe B.K. Gupta, sir, our Dr. N.S. Manoj Kumar, sir, who is the Accounts Officer of JSS Academy of Technical Education, Noida, our Dean Academics, Dr. R.S. Jagdish sir, who has been actively participating in all the activities, academic activities in the campus. Then our Rajanna sir, who is the liaison officer, keeping intact with us, with the environment of in and around and making us comfortable to the management in giving us all the opportunities to do its best. I'm also thankful to our esteemed experts of the day, which is going to produce their best as of their concern, which I will thank in the way that they did not even think twice to give us the opportunity to welcome them for this International Faculty Development Program. I am very much thankful to all my experts of all these 5 days International Faculty Development Program. Thank you all very much. I would also like to thank our, you can say, coordinators and the team members of the department, Dr. Shivani Dubey, Mr. Hanuman Rao, then Tara Rawat ma'am, who is going to host the program for the day. Then Gunjan Srivastav ma'am, who has been actively participating in the, you can say, Saturday's event. Then our Shobha ma'am, who is going to participate as a coordinator for the tomorrow's event of the International Faculty Development Program. I would also like to thank in absentia my friends and my dear colleagues who have been the backbone in giving us the environment and really giving the participants to the extent possible in their best of their knowledge. In the end, but not the least, again, I would like to thank our respected principal, sir, Dr. Gurulingappa M. Patel, sir, who has given us the best possible opportunity and the best environment to create for all the participants around the globe, in which we have received more than 1,000 participants for this active, you can say, International Faculty Development Program. But maximum participants are from state, you can say, Uttar Pradesh. And also we have received participants from abroad, where 9 are foreigners and 7 to 8 participants as NRI. Rest all are, you can say, from the Indian participants. I would take this opportunity and again welcome everyone to take the best out of our best resources that we have produced for you all, to give you the best from this International Faculty Development Program. I once again welcome everyone and our participants. Over to our coordinator of the day, Ms. Tara Rawat ma'am, who is going to host the program for the day and making us feel the best possible in her, you can say, communication. Thank you, and over to you, Tara Rawat ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir. A very good morning to one and all present, and it gives me an immense pleasure in welcoming you all. I really feel honored to welcome our today's speakers, Ms. Madhu Vajpayee, Dr. Surendra Chaudhary, Dr. Jitendra Bhandari, and Mr. Suresh Basavraj. Last but not least, I would like to welcome all the participants from various institutes who are taking keen interest in our International FTP program. And I'm sure they will enrich with knowledge after the completion of this program. So before start the session, I would like to welcome our first speaker, Ms. Madhu Vajpayee, and I would like to brief about her profile. Ms. Madhu Vajpayee is a founder of Technologies, Information Security, Mobility, and Blockchain Specialist. She is an accomplished visionary with domestic and international experience in strategic planning, customer engagement, project, team management, and operations, result-oriented decisive leader with proven success in establishing and growing operations, improving customer satisfaction. Her expertise are blockchain, mobility, networking and network management protocols, AWS serverless architecture, payment transactions, device driver development, firmware development, and she is also co-organizer of Linux Foundation Blockchain Hyperledger Project Community in Noida, and also co-organizer of Noida Blockchain Technology and Applications Meetup. I welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Tara, ma'am. So, hello and good morning, everyone. I'm going to share my screen.
Hearty welcome, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Hope all of you can hear me properly and can see my screen.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Okay. Give me a minute. So, welcome everyone to this session, and I'm Madhu Vajpayee. During this COVID-19 time, our online activities are going manifold. Whether it's education, whether it's a business or online shopping or entertainment, right? We all are experiencing more and more activities in the online world. And so we are also experiencing some different kind of experience, like some threats from outside. Like I'm not sure if you have experienced it or not, but I have experienced this. Let me take a few examples where first day when my daughter was attending the online class, a few people intruded that Zoom session and they started abusing in front of the small kids. They really had extremely bad experience, which they can never forget in their life. The behavior those intruders were showing in the school class, a kids session, that was really means they I'm sure that they are not going to forget it for the long time. Along with that, during this time, my brother, he has got some threatening mail asking for some ransomware that they have fetched some, they have got some videos of his private movements, and they are going to publish it to the internet. And they were asking, in lieu of that, they were asking for some money, right? So these are some of the experiences, I'm sure Zoom experience most of us have experienced. And along with that, you may have a different kind of experience. And that was the reason actually I chose this topic, that information security in our daily life. You may not have experienced, but at least you should be aware of that, what kind of data misuse can be there. This session is not going to be a cybersecurity specific, right? It may start with something, some awareness kind of, what kind of threats you may have from the, if someone hacks your data. But along with that, this is more from a computer science perspective, because I know that you all are quite professional, and you need not to have that level of cybersecurity related stuff. And if there is a need, maybe we can have another session on that as well. But right now I am going to focus on the computer science perspective, how actually internally a software takes care of all these threats and precautions where people have lesser experience. This cannot be avoided. See, the vulnerability and those online threats, they cannot be avoided. Some precautions has to be taken at the software end, some precautions has to be taken at the user's end, right? So everyone has their own responsibility. So this particular session is going to focus specifically on the software perspective, from the coder's perspective. We are not going into that deep, so not to worry. And feel free to interrupt me if you have a question. Okay, moving next. How can I avoid this? Tara ma'am, can I avoid this waiting room messages? Maybe if everyone joins, then probably we were not going to have this.
I just joined them. Wait a minute.
Yeah. So I'll start with brief of about myself. I have been into IT industry for past 25 years, involved into code development. I'm still a coder. I love to code. But along with that, I have to run the organization. I have been leading a senior position in some of the MNCs as well. So out of these 25 years, around 15 years I have spent in the information security domain, especially the software development or the product and the related development within the information security domain. So I have worked with SafeNet, which is now Gemalto, and recently Gemalto was acquired by some other company. I believe that's a Thales, right? Before that, an Indian company, Network Programs, IIT Kanpur, I got an opportunity to work for a couple of years. And then the Softech Limited, which was one of the premier in the compiler development. Once in my time when I was in the college, and probably some of you may have used the softwares, COBOL and C compiler. When Microsoft was not there in the picture with respect to the C compiler. After spending couple of good years in the corporate, I founded Rhymus Technologies because I wanted to do something on my own, right? Some of the accolades which I feel proud about. Tara ma'am, can we avoid this waiting room?